The EAS reaction can also be used to introduce a sulfonic acid group onto an aromatic ring. In this lesson, we're going to look at two sets of conditions that can cause this reaction to occur. We will first look at the sulfonation of benzene with sulfuric acid to produce our sulfonic acid. This will shed light on the subtleties of our second mechanism, where we use sulfur trioxide. To produce the electrophile needed for this reaction, two molecules of sulfuric acid must react. This equilibrium is going on to a small extent in a solution of sulfuric acid. Let's add on our lone pairs to keep track of them a little bit better. And then we can show the OH group of one molecule of sulfuric acid becoming protonated by the acidic proton on a second molecule of sulfuric acid. This gives the conjugate base of sulfuric acid and this oxonium. Keeping track of our charges, notice that our first molecule gave up a proton and gained an extra lone pair. This gives it the formal negative charge on oxygen. The second molecule of sulfuric acid shared a lone pair to become protonated, and that's how we get the oxonium ion with the positive charge. Now we're going to show water act as a leaving group to generate our electrophile. But notice two atoms away, we have another oxygen atom. So we can facilitate the departure of the leaving group by using its lone pair. From this process, we get water and a protonated form of sulfur trioxide, which is a great electrophile. Benzene can now attack with its double bond to give an intermediate carbocation. The resonance-stabilized conjugate base of sulfuric acid is not a good nucleophile, so we can show water deprotonating this molecule to form our sulfonic acid. The reaction we've just shown is rather slow. This is because we're depending on the equilibration of a strong acid in solution to form small amounts of protonated sulfur trioxide, which can then push the reaction forward when it reacts with benzene. But that overall equilibration is not very favorable, so this reaction does take some time. We can carry out this reaction more efficiently using sulfur trioxide in sulfuric acid. This reagent is called fuming sulfuric acid, and when you open the bottle, it does indeed smoke. Do this in a fume hood. It's very corrosive. This mechanism can be drawn a couple ways. Notice above, we generated a protonated form of sulfur trioxide. Now, the protonation of SO3 may be the first step in this reaction under certain conditions. However, benzene can also attack sulfur trioxide directly. And we'll show that mechanism here. Benzene attacks SO3, pushing the electrons up onto oxygen. Restoring aromaticity in this molecule is a strong driving force, so some people opt to show a spontaneous deprotonation here. But we also have appropriate bases in solution to do this deprotonation. If we use sulfur trioxide to do the deprotonation, we can create that great electrophile that we generated in the above mechanism. So, we'll show another molecule of sulfur trioxide deprotonating benzene, and a final protonation of this anion will give our sulfonic acid, which was drawn above. Let's take a look at the properties of the sulfonic acid derivative that we've just made. This is an electron withdrawing group. We can show how electron density is pulled out of the ring using one of the sulfur-oxygen double bonds. This resonance form has positive character at the ortho position of the aromatic ring. We can continue to push electrons around the ring and show that there's positive character at the para and the other ortho position of this aromatic ring. Thus, the sulfonic acid group is a deactivating group. It pulls the electrons out of the ring that benzene needs to undergo further electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. The electrons within the ring are less available to attack electrophiles. On this compound, the metacarbons are the most electron-rich. So when we treat benzene sulfonic acid with a powerful enough electrophile, remember the electrophile needs to be pretty powerful now that the ring is deactivated, the new group will be introduced at the meta position. In this lesson, we looked at two methods for the sulfonation of benzene. We then looked at the properties of the derivative that we made, benzene sulfonic acid. We saw that the introduction of this group makes benzene less reactive to further EAS reactions. However, when it does react, the groups will be added at the meta position.